Get ready to match the stars from Charlie's Angels, David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Gibson Reilly, from Ladies' Man, Betty Kennedy, from Mork and Mindy, Robert Donner, and Marcia Wallace, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Hello, hello,
hi, John.
Hello there, friend.
How do you do? Welcome to you. Haven't seen you in a while. Haven't seen you in a while.
No.
Haven't ever seen you before on the stage.
You're probably just as well.
Attaboy, an especially hearty welcome and a nice kiss on the lips. Oh, he would. Hey, listen, it's time. We don't do this too often. To do a little fan mail.
Uh-oh. And
this is a typical fan letter. Someone who wrote to me and said, "Dear Gene Rayburn, R-A-B-E-R, says, I watch your show Match Game on March 24, 1980. I would like to correct a statement you made about hogs don't live in barns. Take it from a 13-year-old farm kid who has been seen hogs being raised in a barn. I just thought maybe some of you city people should be better informed. I live on a farm and... That's a hog. The hogs. I live on a farm in Columbia City, Indiana. We raise and sell fat hogs. Here is a list of animals that live in barns. Pigs, cows, horses, and cats. In case you ever have such a question on your show, this list will help you. I bet some of you city people don't even know what a boar, sow, gilt, fat hog, or feeder pig are.
I do, but I'm not at liberty to say.
If you will read this on the live television, I will keep watching your show.
Why don't you feed the animals before they die? Instead of watching TV.
That's right. Yay! Well, anyways. That's it for the last 6 months there. Hello, Donna. How do you say your name?
Dedekum.
Donna Dedekum and Marion Duncan. Would you please welcome me to Chris DeCross? Now, each of you will play two games. We want to welcome you and find out a little bit about you. Marion?
I'm originally from Philadelphia, but I've been in L.A. for 11 years. I'm a teacher.
Wait a minute. You've been here 11 years?
11 years.
All right. Okay.
I am a teacher and a writer and a proud mother of a 15-year-old who thinks he's like Magic Johnson.
Uh-huh. Does he play that game?
He plays well.
Yes.
Very well.
Magic is really something else,
he's
isn't
terrific.
It?
Terrific.
Well, I hope he does have a great career there. Now, Donna, let's find out about you.
Well, I'm originally from New York. We're almost neighbors.
Yeah.
And I've been living here for about 3 years, and I work for a major airline.
All right. Good luck to both of you ladies.
Thank you.
Let's begin by asking Marianne to make a decision about A or B.
I'll pick A.
A it is. Here we go. Did you hear?
I'm so sorry. It's not that I'm not excited to be here, really.
Yeah.
But yawn was totally...
yawn, right? As
frozen.
I start to read the first question, you yawn?
It's sheer excitement. I'm worn out already.
Sure.
Remember the play I did in New York? She invested in it, and it lasted 4 days, and she looked at me in the hall like... I said, I'll give you the money back tonight. I mean, she just,
before they cashed the check.
I know it. They booed, I heard.
Oh, well.
Did you hear that voluptuous Velma had her chest insured for $1 million?
Uh-oh.
Did you hear about that?
No.
Well, now, what's strange is she had it insured against blank.
Oh! I got it. I have a wonderful ass. Don't just kill.
Here we go, Mary. Did you hear that voluptuous Velma had her chest insured for $1 million? What's strange is she had it insured against...
robbery.
Robbery is good.
Oh, it is good.
Isn't that good?
Good.
Oh,
good.
Didn't want anybody to steal them.
No, that's
jewels.
Right. No, don't take them with you, please. Just use them here.
We missed you, David.
Oh. I said deflation.
Deflation.
Good.
Such a downer, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
No, you neglected to say who it was.
Voluptuous Velma.
I thought you said Twiggy. I said inflation.
You must listen.
That was the big, wonderful answer that you had. The correct answer, Jane.
There it is. Welcome to Marianne.
Had it insured $1 million of strangers, you had it insured against?
Deflating.
Deflating. All right. Now, here's your first time at bat. Okay, Bob.
I'm so proud of this answer.
Good.
A flat. Thank you. It made me feel much better. I saved this one.
Very good.
Well, how are you going to follow that act?
His excuse is that it's his first time.
Right, right.
I've been here before and I have no excuse. Floods.
Floods. Well, that could happen.
It could. You never
right.
know.
Now, let's see what we have for Donna. Ed said, you know you've had too much to drink when you go out into the street and try to teach a blank to fetch. Here we go. Donna. Ed said, you know you've had too much to drink when you go out into the street and try to teach a blank to fetch.
A policeman.
A policeman. That would be a confrontation. What'd you say to that?
I didn't get off the curb. I had him stop and talk to a parking meter.
A parking meter. He loves his answers, no matter how bad they are.
somebody has to.
He's also speaking from personal experience. I knew him in the old days, before he went on the wagon. Remember what fun we used to have?
Well, I said a member of the police dept.
Uh-huh. Look at that.
So I said 1-1. I said a hydrant.
A hydrant? All good responses. I was only kidding, David. I thought that was quite good.
Excellent. Yes.
Betty, what do you got here for us?
Okay, I thought that you should teach a drunk to fetch, because they don't do much else, you know. They drink, so teach them to fetch.
Right, okay. Right.
We get it, Betty.
Thank you.
I've known Mr. Doyle when a curb was a definite threat. But we won't go into that now. I said a cop.
A cop?
Look at that.
Two for her.
Yay.
Good. It turned out to be a good answer. I thought it was going to be a disaster, but she's doing well with it. What have you got for
her? Well, then, what do you know?
Yes.
I said what Charles said, my idol. Fire hydrant.
Charles is your idol.
Charles is my
idol. All right. So at the end of round one, 2-1 is the score. Your favor. Round two coming up in a moment. Now this for you. Here we go to round two. And Donna, since you're ahead, you may go first. Be it is what she wants, and that's what she gets. One safecracker said to another,
"Hey, that new guy is a real weirdo. Take a look. Take a look. First he sanded his fingertips, now he's sanding his blank. We like you. Watch him feel secure.
The game's over for you.
One safecracker said to another, "That new guy is a real weirdo. Take a look. First he sanded his fingertips, now he's sanding his blank."
Oh, gosh. This is a tough one.
I think it's an easy one.
Onward, Christian soldier.
Mm-hmm. I'll just say.
Wish I had another farm litter. What?
Now he's sanding his safe. I can't think of an answer.
Don't pick on her.
That's right. You get up here. No, don't. Oh, wait, no, just kidding.
Watch it.
What do you got for it?
Well, I've got a couple of incisors. Teeth.
His teeth, all right. Charles?
Moving on with this brilliant question, I said nose.
Nose is all right. Any part of the face would have been okay. He's a weirdo, you know. First he sands his fingertips, because that's what you do to make your fingertips more sensitive if you're going to fiddle around with the combination lock
on
the safe.
We get it.
Well, I mean, obviously she didn't get it. I'm explaining it for somebody.
I think we have the IQ of a plant around here.
Yeah. Yes.
Well, then I thought he'd sand his ear so he could hear better.
That's good. Yay! Yeah. Yes.
I'm sorry I said that about you. Toe tips.
What? Now there's good. That's a good answer.
Why, thank you.
Very good. Fingers and toes. Okay, Donna, you're getting the hang of it now, aren't you? Maybe too late. We'll find out right now. You need 1 to tie, 2 to win. Skinny Mickey is so skinny.
How skinny is he?
I'm gonna tell you. He got an athletic scholarship to go to college as a blank. That's how skinny he is.
Lose anything for incorrect spelling?
Oh, no. Spelling doesn't count here. Good. We'll figure it out. Just to give a good shot at it, and that's all you need.
Rough.
Skinny Mickey is so skinny, he got an athletic scholarship to go to college as a blank.
Toothpick.
Now, that's skinny.
That's skinny. That's him. See, we said go to college. He got a scholarship. Listen. I thought you were going to be wheeled off here, and but I see we're going to have to wheel her off now. Oh, boy. All right.
I was thinking along athletic lines.
Yeah, well, that's what we were,
possibly it would be a secret weapon on the football field. He would go there as an invisible
end. An invisible
end. Jesus, that's great, David.
This is the visible end.
We weren't going to get that convoluted, David.
I see.
What?
I wish to say, I really think this question stinks. I'm with her. Toothpick, what difference does it make what anybody says? It's still a rotten, lousy, stinking question. And
isn't she
sweet? You'll never get off the fence, will she?
Isn't she sweet?
Wish she was.
Javelin is good. Now, that's a good response.
Anything athletic in college.
What do you got there, Betty?
Okay, I thought he should be a pole vaulter.
Another good one. Hey, good.
You know, when it's going good, you get here fast.
Yes.
Pole vaulter.
Pole vaulter. Now, you got to match Marcia a few times, stay the game. Say toothpick.
Oh, I'd love a toothpick.
All right, you said it.
Pencil.
Pencil. Yeah. So that means Donna wins the game. Come on down, Donna. Take your place there, if you would, please. We'll see you a little bit later. I'm going to wheel you off now, and you come back a little bit later for game number two. But right now, we'll see how much money you're going to win here, because you could win a big bundle over $10,000. Let's see how it goes. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank the ship. $500 for you if you give us the answer they wrote down most often. $250 for the second most popular answer, and $100 for the third. Now, three of the six stars can help, but call on the ones who are establishing eyeball contact. The ones who are not looking at you don't have an answer. You see how simple it is?
Oh, God. No. Charles, would you look down here, please?
Charles. Charles has money. He doesn't want to be called on. That's why he's not looking at you. Now, Betty Kennedy is looking at you.
Okay, I want Charles first, though.
You don't understand. I don't know how you got up here. I don't know how you won this game.
She's winning, isn't she?
Yeah, she walked right up. No, yeah, she is winning. All right, you want Charles.
Abandon the ship.
Abandon the ship. All right.
Marcia.
No, Marcia, you don't understand what I'm saying.
She keeps looking up over that thing.
Oh, well, she's hiding her eyes, you see. She doesn't want...
Sweet.
All right, Marcia, she's called on you.
Oh, what a treat for me. Sink the ship?
Sink the ship.
That's what I thought.
One more.
Now I have one more.
See, now nobody's looking at you.
Yeah. Robert, please.
Save the ship.
So you have save the ship, abandon ship, and sink the ship. You want one of those or one of your own?
Oh, ship's in trouble.
Abandon ship is what she wants. What would you say, audience? Don't give up the ship.
Oh, don't give up.
Oh, we're so stupid.
Don't give up the ship. Very good.
All right, let's see what we have under the $100 number.
Oh, no.
Don't give up is the audience's answer.
Big deal.
All right, let's see if we have abandon ship under the $250 response. Abandoned. What do you think that now you're second guessing? What's under the big one? Save or sink? All right, slide it.
Sink.
Sink. Okay. You'll be playing for a minimum of $2,500 and maybe $5,000. We'll tell you more about that right after this.
That was mine.
Donna's won the $250. That's hers. And multiplied by 10 is 2,500. That's the least you'll play for, Donna. However, we want you to spin the wheel. If you get a lucky spin of the wheel and it lands on one of the stars, names with the star on it, you double it to $5,000. Step right up there and have a go at it, and we'll all root for a double. And here we go.
All right.
Charles, it is. And you did do the double for $5,000. Swing around, face me a little bit, and good luck to you, and this is it.
Good luck to you.
Many blank. Many blank. Many blank. M-A-N-Y. That's right, or any answer. Charles was looking into space with a vacant stare. There he is again, staring into space. Now he's ready. Now, Donna, you give us the answer that he has in the card. We give you $5,000. What do you say to that? Many blank.
I said many thanks.
Many thanks to you. All right. Let's turn around and find out what Charles has. Many thanks for what she says, Charles.
The most famous one is the longer one, and I didn't think she would go for the longer one. Many happy returns.
Many happy returns.
That's what I'd say. Thanks.
Thank you. All right, soon as it stops, you can get aboard the merry-go-round. There you go. Welcome back, Marianne. All right. And now, if you're all set, she's very excited because she's got a bundle of money there. Well, there is the souvenir card. Thank you very much.
My shoes are from Palm Beach.
Marianne, A or B?
This time I'll take B.
Anything you say. Tough Tony is so tough.
How tough is
Tough Tony?
Once he ate a blank with the shell still on.
That's tough.
That is tough.
What is it?
You. Barefoot boy with cheek.
Get him to put his shoes on, I'd be very grateful. I mean, I may faint over here. You may notice those tears are from the odor, not from sadness.
Maybe it's a combination of your perfume and cheek pearls.
Let's not talk about my jewelry, having been burgled.
Oh,
can you imagine that?
Here we go. Tough Tony is so tough. Once he ate a blank with the shell still on.
Oh, that is tough. A macadamia nut. A nut.
Oh.
A nut. All right. She said a nut with the shell still on.
A macadamia nut. I know what she means. They are terribly, terribly hard. I was thinking more along the lines of a 200-year-old turtle.
A 200-year-old turtle. Wow, that would be tough.
Very tough.
Cook them all day.
And going.
Yes.
Well, you know, I come from Maine. You know what they've got up there, dear?
That's
we
right.
all go crazy for.
Oh, yes.
Nice lobster.
Right. Lobster with the shell still on. What do you got?
Flower clap.
Good old egg. What's egg. Wrong with a simple egg?
Nothing's wrong with a simple egg.
When you give a rotten answer, they say, what's wrong with a simple egg, right? Because it's a stinky answer.
So tough, you ate a blank with the shell still on.
Thanks, Brett. Real stinky answer.
You're making friends and influencing people.
The world over.
All right,
I think
Robert.
Brett is a very bright woman. Lobster.
Lobster. Right. Well, you're entitled to your opinion. Yes, Miss Marcia?
Mr. Jean. I'm not from Maine, dear.
No.
I'm from Iowa, where we have hogs.
Oh, you do?
Oh, do we have
letter
hogs?
Writers.
They don't grow in the barn, do they, or do they grow?
Well, them? I've been in a barn with a hog or two, but...
Okay.
Oh, Mark, I love
Very it. Good. That's the best remark of the day, dear.
It is? Gee, then I'll just shut up and say lobster.
All right. When was it? Who set her up with the straight line, Chuck? Okay.
No.
This is the middle of round one, and we have no score. You'll have a question later. Now we have this for America. Thank you all. Join us for our match game. Goodbye.
Bye. Some contestants will receive Baker's Secret from Echo, the silicone-coated non-stick bakeware. It's the easy way to better baking. Makes cleanup easy as pie. And an exciting assortment of Crayola art and activity kits with everything children need for hours of imaginative play. It's fun to create with Crayola. And a Betty Crocker cookbook can bake someone happy with Super Moist. Putting in the mix that makes it unbelievably moist. Other cakes may be moist, but they're not super moist. And a tray and chunky family-sized bars in four varieties. Each breaks into 24 thick bite-sized pieces. Chunky, thicker in chocolate for real chocolate lovers. And food keepers and Uncle Ben takes the time to make rice right. Uncle Ben select brown rice, naturally high in bran, fiber, and nutrients. And a calculator and complete cleans and polishes all kinds of furniture without leaving a greasy film to streak or smear. From Johnson Wax. And Clear-Aid hydrocortisone for itching from insect bites, detergents, poison ivy, dermatitis. Now there's something better itching than scratching. Clear-Aid from Squib. Come on.